Hello, everyone.
Hello.
And welcome back. I'm Luke.
I'm Morgan.
And this is our double Nuzlocke playthrough of Pokemon Sun and Moon.
I guess I'll go ahead and read the rules.
Uh-huh.
Rules of a Nuzlocke run. Number one, if a Pokemon faints, we have to release it because it is considered dead. Rule number two, we can only catch the first new Pokemon we encounter in each area.
Which you've already done in this area.
Right. Rule number three, we have to play in set mode. And rule number four, we cannot use held items in battle, but held items are okay.
And now this is going to be a little bit of a different episode from what we've done in the past because, frankly, our audio got murdered by Audacity.
So this is after the fact that we're recording this.
Yeah,
right now.
We have already recorded this episode, but the dialogue was completely unusable, and I'll drop in just a little bit here so that you can see what you're just terribly missing out on.
French mouse.
Who cooked the better spaghetti?
See,
all right, I think that's enough.
That was very bad. Yeah. That was very, very bad.
I really hope we remember to drop the audio in so it's not just a giant
not
pause
just an
right
awkward
there.
Silence. Well, I'm going to be editing this episode as soon as we finish this, so we will.
Luke, I don't know if I can relive this.
Just rewatch this specific episode?
This episode was my nightmare. It was my hell.
Listen, it was a hero's journey. We went through a struggle. We went on an adventure, and we went through the underworld.
This is like the low point of the hero's journey. Like the lowest low point.
The lowest
as it gets.
Point that it could be. But you know what? That's for later. That's
so
that's,
low that we're under the ground, buried under the ground.
But that's for later. Why are you bringing it back right now? Right now, everything's great. Lily's showing me that what a Pokemon Center is. Because I had no idea.
Oh yeah, this is when we first went to the Pokemon Center, and I'm struggling to figure out the direction.
Yeah,
to go.
You were just completely lost at this point, frankly.
You had to kind of guide me through here.
It,
you can tell how lost I am. Just look at
as you're just exploring the corners of the screen.
I'm trying to go up the ledge.
You are so lost.
Running into the sign.
You can see because I'm not doing anything right now.
You're
I'm
just
clearly
watching me
just
struggle.
Trying to help you get to where you need to be.
Yeah.
You had already caught a Rattata in this area, named it Ratatouille.
Very proud of that.
It was very low health when you went into this battle, I'm just looking at now.
And I remember telling you, I'm still not used to this.
Yeah, because you left a Pokemon in with like 4 HP. But I'm slowly making my way through Lily's explanation of what a Pokemart is. And for this episode, I did edit it down a little bit because, you know what, there were just some long pauses where we were talking.
The episode ran an hour and 40 minutes.
An hour and 40 minutes!
I believe it's an hour now.
A lot of that was just us...
shopping.
That is true.
We spent a lot of time
we'll
shopping.
Also get to that. Why you gotta tell all the secrets that come in this episode?
I'm doing like a next time on. Next time.
Except it's just the same time on.
It is.
This time on. That's just called watching the show.
Like 40 minutes later on.
Can you imagine if TV shows did that? This is how the episode will end. Now join us. The cafe is also may offer more than just drinks.
Oh, did I tell you?
If you know what I mean.
Okay, so we've recorded, I think, 5 episodes at this point when we're returning to this now.
Uh-huh.
To do the sort of, like, overlay commentary. I finally figured out where you got that rare candy.
You got it from this man.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Did you know that?
I know that because I was watching this episode while editing it and saw myself get the rare candy.
Yeah, so I realized that way too late.
Yeah. As we will also see.
I'm still struggling. Oh, cut.
Here we are. It took you so long to find the Pokemon Center.
It took me so long to get there. I went every single...
We had to get to that point.
I'm sorry.
Frankly.
It took so long you had to cut to it.
And see? There he is.
There you are.
There's that man giving me his candy.
And then later when I was like, where'd you get it? You're like, I don't know.
Well, I couldn't remember at that point. I don't remember every old man that gives me his candy.
Oh, boy.
You know, it happens a lot.
Oh,
I've got a very sweet face.
She just said those fateful words. We should head to the trainer school.
Hey, what could go wrong at the trainer school? It's just a school for beginner Pokemon trainers. I'm sure it's going to be super easy and fun and a great time had by all.
Everything is going to be great, I'm sure.
You don't sound super confident.
Hey, very close to the number... Oh.
Hey, you said you weren't going to spoil anything.
I'm not saying anything.
You're a little fixated. I gotta give it to you.
I'm sorry, I'm so shaken up by this.
Look
I
at
never
that man
recovered.
Give me his pineapple juice.
Look at him like with that arm motion.
He's beckoning
like,
yeah,
me he's beckoning you
to
forth.
That sweet juice.
I'm just picking up so many potions.
And
judging
that man
by
is...
my experience in the game thus far.
Yeah. He'd like to offer my Pokemon something on the house. We'll never find out what it is because I can't remember.
And there's that Tauros.
Oh, the town celebrity, you mean? The Tauros that's everywhere?
That Tauros is just blocking every road.
Just hanging out. At this point, we were really confused because you're playing Pokemon Sun and I'm playing Pokemon Moon, but your game right now is all at night.
So far, it's been all at night. It's still all
it's
at night.
It's really confusing.
It is weird. I wonder when the time is going to change again. Like, is it just... Is all of this taking place in one day? I think that's the case.
Like, is that... I feel like it's got to take place over more than one day, because how can you go to four islands in one day?
No, I think, like, each island is
Hey, wait,
is
we
like
need your
day.
Sweet voice.
Wait, this isn't my voice.
Wait, who has... Do we not have a Kukui voice?
We don't.
But welcome to the... No, that's just my voice. And, we need a teacher voice, for sure. Professor Kukui. Is this the child you've told me about? I feel like that's a... Is he gabbing about us? Yeah, put her through the ringer, teach!
That's all right. That's like a... That's
four
like
a, trainers!
He likes to, like, call out the number four of
Four things. Islands! Four trainers! Four trainers here for... At school, Luke and Morgan! Actually,
I was going to say it started out as like a gym teacher voice and now it's transforming into something else.
I am channeling my best Joey from Yu-Gi-Oh! Actually.
Oh, okay.
Was the kind of beacon that I had in my head that I was racing towards.
We got an AXP share here, and in which we're questioning why we would need it.
And we're questioning if we should use it or not in our Nuzlocke. We start off with not, I believe.
Yeah, not.
And we,
I actually think I ever turned it
off. I know, I think you completely forgot to turn it off,
I thought
frankly.
It had already been off.
No, it automatically sets to on. But yeah, I turned it off because I'm a true hero.
Lesson begin.
Let the lessons begin. She may not look all that tough, but she trains her kids right.
But that teach trains her kids right.
Is that what he said?
Yeah.
I can't read very quickly. Now that we're going through it at different speeds.
He's going to give us some advice.
Yeah, something that might help. Why are we taking so long on this?
I don't know.
What are we talking about?
Can we just not read?
Once you fight a species of that Pokemon once, you can easily see what types of moves will work best on it in your next battle. That's true. We actually did discover that already, though, at this point. Wandering around the tall grass, we'll meet a lot of different Pokemon. And this is when we actually, so I just run straight into the school. I have no idea what's holding you back.
I don't know what I'm doing.
You
it's
just
kind
have
of
to...
funny watching me again. I'm sure I'm saying something very smart.
Oh, I'm sure. I'm 100% confident that that's it.
Oh, no, I was talking about how she's going to restore our health.
Oh.
I was also commenting on, like, the amount of times that she's said...
Oh, I went ahead and cut ahead to things, to points where we're actually doing things.
I think I was talking about the amount of times that she said that she doesn't like it when Pokemon fight. She said that like 5 times.
That's true. She said so often that specifically that she hates to see Pokemon hurt.
Yeah, she said it like every 5th sentence.
Every time that we talk to her, she tells us so much about how she hates Pokemon being hurt. And as soon as I saw a Bonsly, I was like, oh, this game's getting a little serious.
Why is that?
I don't know. A Bonsly's just not a Pokemon I anticipate a young trainer having.
Your sausage can handle a Bonsly.
Listen, my sausage can handle just about any tree or sapling that you send its way.
I'm having a bird-on-bird duel.
I'm pretty sure that's called cockfighting and illegal in pretty much everywhere.
Who has the better bird?
Is it you?
It is.
Well, they're both level 8, so who knows, man.
And what? We're both using echoed voice.
Yeah.
So it's all about who can endure.
It wasn't great. That was a pretty substantial hit.
I live life on the edge. I take risks.
You know what? You live life very, very close to the edge.
And you let your sausage fall asleep.
No, he's just always is kind of doing that.
That's just his natural state.
Apparently, I'm hovering over the potion. I think maybe because I'm trying to coach you through what to do, because he clearly doesn't need a potion.
Yeah, I was trying to debate whether or not I should switch out, because that third echoed voice of that picky peck would have hurt.
It would have murdered you. Yeah. 100%.
So, like, I could either go for it or switch out and hope that that third echoed voice doesn't kill me.
See, at this point, you should have realized that EXP share was definitely on, as after a single fight, three of your Pokemon leveled up.
I don't think I was actually paying too much attention to that fact.
It's hard to pay attention to two games at once and talk.
It is.
Turns out.
And, like, also make sure you're keeping your energy and voice up. It's...
Yeah. I'm feeling a lot more energetic when I'm not having to also read and comprehend what's going on.
And, like, crane my neck to look down at the 3DS.
Also that.
Oof.
I'm
getting healed here.
I'm licking up that Bonsly. And that was clearly a mistake.
It's really, like, a nice touch that your mixtape knows lick, honestly.
Yeah, right? Like, cats should know lick. That's just who
they
are as people.
Why am I weaving back and forth? Do you see me going in like a serpent?
How did you find a potion under there? I never got that.
Huh.
Oh, God, my licks tape.
Your licks tape?
My licks tape brings all the boys to the yard. And they're like, what's a licks tape? Got down to 5 HP right there. Look at us just pummeling toddlers.
I know. And that one kid right here is just like, I'm too good for you.
You want to know why I'm standing here? I'm the strongest, that's why, is what that guy said.
I guess so. He knows where he stands in the world.
Yeah. Listen, if you know it, flaunt it, right? That's that saying?
I guess so.
Yeah.
I'll teach you the tactics I learned here at school by beating you with them.
Says a little tiny boy with one Pokemon.
Oh, and then here's where we were like, oh, Youngster Joey, he's definitely going to have a Rattata, right?
Because that's Youngster Joey's whole deal. Nope. He's got a quality Metapod.
I don't understand.
Why even exist, Youngster Joey? All you're bringing to the table is a Metapod.
Needless to say, I was very happy that it was a Metapod.
You crushed it. Fairly quickly, that is true.
There's very few times where I actually get to use moves that are super effective because of my type coverage.
Yeah, considering two of your three are birds?
Yeah.
Absolutely.
Oh, and I actually found out recently that you can cure, which I never knew, you can cure status conditions with that care by pressing the Y button?
Yeah.
Yeah, I never realized that.
It says that right when you enter the screen.
Yeah, I guess I just hadn't, like, noticed.
No, it's okay. I can barely read either. If there's a reason we both draw for a living, it's because words were never our strong suit.
Especially numbers.
Oh, yeah. Let's not even get started on math. Ugh.
So I can never calculate how much HP my Pokemon has and whether it'll be worth it.
Yeah, and if it's going to die in the next hit or not.
I'm very, very, like, carefully,
carefully walking
grass.
Through this grass. Yeah. Though this is when we realize we can catch a new Pokemon in this area. Is right around here.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Wait, yeah.
And I believe we're having that discussion right now.
Yeah, because we're... Yep. And then I go running through
just
the grass.
Starting to waddle through it.
Because, we've been talking about, you know, what does and doesn't count as a new area, and we finally figured it out.
Anytime that the saved game would tell you a different location that you're in, or basically, you know, like, Route 1 or Route 1 outskirts technically show up as two different things.
Also, I was so excited to get a Magnemite here.
I was really curious as to how you were going to get a Magnemite here, considering two of your three are weak to...
Think of the type coverage!
It would be very, very good type coverage.
Oh, steel and electric?
Yeah, I just crossfaded because I'm pretty sure you had a very long battle with this Magnemite.
Did I?
Yeah, no, it was actually something around like 5 minutes.
Huh, I don't remember that.
Yeah.
But yeah, that Magnemite, see, just you can already tell that I need it because of the way it's destroying
me. Yeah, the way that it's crushing. Absolutely. At this point in the game, I'm very adamant about using Sausage, even though he's not really great at anything just yet.
But he's so cute.
He's very cute, though, is the thing. He brings us, or she, I always call Sausage a he, because frankly, it's going to become a slow bro, and like, that is just completely a masculine name, but I don't want to misgender. And you caught the Magnemite.
Yeah. My new best friend.
You have to decide what to name it.
Oh, that's always the hardest part for me.
Yeah. No, that's also something that I'm almost positive that I edited down. We'll see. But, yeah, no, I was very adamant about using Sausage, even though she was not really actually hurting anything in any significant way. And then finally, I believe you came to the conclusion of what your name should be.
Oh, right? Wait, no, I decided that fairly quickly because that's my favorite electric type Pokemon name.
Oh.
Watson. I love it. Ever since that Gen 3 gym leader Watson, I've loved that name.
And this is when I came across my first wild Pokemon of the area.
Yeah.
The Alola Meowth. Which is pretty cool.
Look at that sassy stance.
And I was thinking, you know, obviously Alola Meowth evolves into a like Alola Persian, which looks exactly like Garfield.
Oh, I love how this Rowlet is always covered in like cotton somehow, like... How'd you get that all over you, little scamp?
Yeah, what's he doing? He's in the Pokeball most of the time. How's he getting covered in cotton?
I just love that it looks like he was rolling around in the field.
Does your potato vape? Because it's ripping all that cotton? And then we continued our journey. I believe, this is when I go to catch the Pokemon that I determined. Because Garfield... You know, but I saw that this Meowth is a female. This Meowth is also a lady, as is, like, the entirety of my entire team.
Yeah, you know, I never run into lady Pokemon.
Yeah.
Maybe once.
I'm all about the female Ghostbusters. And so, because of that, I was inspired to make an all-female team, just completely by chance.
And then I enter here through the side door.
I didn't even know that was a door!
I'll just come in through here and scare everyone.
Hello, I am teacher now.
Just gonna interrupt this classroom session to talk to all of these children.
Hey, teach, I know you got something going in here, but these little kids have things to teach me, okay? We occasionally ask Professor Kukui to run a special class for our school. What's that class? How to be a sexy professor?
Oh, I love Alola Meowth, like... animation.
Yeah, all his claws in business.
I can read. Here, watch.
And I came up with the perfect name for this Alola Meowth. For this female Alola Meowth. Normal. The
can
female
you explain
cat.
Why?
It's the female cat from Garfield.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's 100% the reason why. And I immediately fell in love with it because it's a dark type and that's perfect.
And also, it's just
such a cutie. Such a cutie.
Meh.
What are you talking to? Oh, that's another Meowth. Do the Alola Pokemon have different cries? Because that's definitely not... Like a like normal Meowth would say like nyan or meow.
Yeah.
But that one's that's devilish. Like, it's a little devilish boy.
Okay, I think I might just not talk to it anymore. Quick Claw.
Ooh, yeah. You picked up a Quick Claw.
Did you ever get that Quick Claw?
Yeah, of course I did. I'm not going to see you get a Quick Claw and then not get a Quick Claw.
Very useful, honestly. Yeah, I don't think Potato has the greatest speed, so...
No, it definitely is lacking in that particular department.
Which is unfortunate, because it really needs it. It could use a little help in that
area. It wouldn't be bad for you to have a quick Pokemon.
But yeah, here I'm just checking out which Pokemon needs it most.
I'm picking up Quick Claw as well. And here you're going in after that Bonsly.
Is that what you want? Huh? Is it? This kid is bullying me.
Is that? Well, and it's a video game, so you know what that means? It's a cyber bully. That's what
She's
that is, right?
She's gonna show me up close and personal.
Look at her little sassy hands, too. Those little sassy sausage fingers. Oh, and at this moment, we realize that my sausage, it's brave, and its characteristic is it likes to run.
Which is hilarious.
Just completely untrue.
It's gonna be like waddling down the road really fast. And
so cute. Waddling down the road of life.
It's like a chubby pug who can't run correctly, but it's like super cute.
Aw, she definitely snorts, doesn't she?
Yeah.
Aw. I think this is maybe the moment where you realize, oh, a rock type is pretty bad for most of my Pokemon.
Actually, Potato could take it out with Leaf.
Oh, that's leafage. True. Yeah, I didn't even think about that. But I think you don't even use that. I'm pretty... Oh.
Wait, yeah, Rock Smash actually would have worked.
Yeah, Rock
but I don't
Smash
think
would
I
have worked, but
get...
it would have been dangerous.
Oh, I didn't want to get hit, I'm pretty sure.
And then I realized that there's this teacher, and there's just this other older dude up here just,
with this,
just
with another
watching his slowpoke.
Yeah.
Just casually viewing.
Yeah.
Slowpoke's
yawn
is a move that can put the opponents to sleep in battle. I was like, this man has nothing for me.
Unless you're giving me an item I want. Nothing to you.
Come on. And then here I decided it was time to take up my career in education.
Crushing the small toddler's dreams here. Very excited about that.
And I am teacher now. And I see, look at me. Look at me give my lecture. I am best Pokemon. Here you are now, teacher.
Oh, here you are battling the strong kid.
That strong kid who just hangs out in the on the blacktop or whatever it is. What is that field supposed to be?
Rising
a soccer
star
field?
Joseph.
And all he has is a Grimer.
When do you like upgrade your title in Pokemon?
From like a preschooler to a rising star?
Yeah.
Guess that's how grades work.
This
grades
is
are actually just
Star Joseph.
Honorific titles. You go from what is it? Preschooler to youngster.
Yeah.
And then from youngster to schoolboy. And I'm just like, oh, it's time to take this Grimer downtown.
And this teacher doesn't want me going upstairs.
I know, right? What are they keeping up there? Secrets, definitely.
Now I'm gonna battle this kid.
What kind of secrets do you think the school has? Dark ones, I bet. Shadows in the closet? That's not that phrase.
She's making me feel really bad about battling my Pokemon.
Yeah, right? When every time she's like, hey, I know you're going to, but could you not?
She's like one of those people who just like silently guilts you.
That Grimer just did a lot of damage to my Nurmal.
And poisoned you.
Yeah.
Oh, man.
I realize maybe this rising star is a star on the rise. And not to be taken too lightly.
All right, time to knock this child down a few pegs.
Critical hits in this game are so scary.
I have bad news for you, Rising Star Joseph.
Oh, yeah, I remember this battle.
But this is our first encounter with Alola Grimer, I think.
Yeah, I think it was too. Who's just drooling lemonade
poison
from the mouth.
Oh, I was going to say, he has like a lemonade goatee.
Yeah. What is that? Like, I know Muk becomes like an oil slick, which I think looks super dope.
Oh, yeah. It's got like radiating colors all across
yeah,
it.
Yeah, but what is Grimer supposed to be?
Like sludge?
I guess. Well, what kind?
I think he's just pollution incarnate.
Are you a sludge scientist? You're a sludge specialist, correct?
Oh, absolutely.
Tell me exactly what kind of sludge this Grimer represents to you. No, you don't have to actually answer it. That's okay.
Okay.
But yeah, I had to switch out multiple times taking down this Grimer.
What will Mixtape do? Man, I do not like that poison.
No, it's not great, frankly. But then I realized, oh, fire is very good
oh,
at destroying poison.
I
yeah, I yawned.
I never
it.
Have any moves that are super effective, it seems like.
It's very nice.
To have moves that are super, to be strong?
Yeah, to be strong and just generally good at video games. Yes, it's very good, actually. I would recommend it when we do our next episode. I will say in the next two, things really take a turn.
in the next two episodes.
Yeah, after this one?
Yeah.
Yeah. We get some... Yeah, we get some nice squad.
I think I'm trying to decide whether or not if he gives me another hit and a poison if I'm able to handle it.
Oh, yeah. I think it's one of those things you don't want to risk.
Yeah.
We'll see if you do, though,
but
retrospectively.
Switching in...
No, taking that hit to switch in, absolutely, can cause a lot more damage.
And then you can never switch back because, you know, I could never use Pico again if I switched back.
Exactly.
So, like, that's essentially just giving up this one Pokemon.
It's a big gamble you have to make. But this is when we realize, oh, right, poison completely just doesn't affect steel, so you'll be fine.
Totally, yeah.
Though Bite still will do a chunk.
Bite is nasty in this game.
And also every Pokemon has it.
Seriously.
I think they realized that, oh hey, almost every Pokemon has a mouth.
Yeah, except for, you know.
Except for Magnemite.
Our friend Magnemite here.
Yeah. Well, I mean, let's not insult him. How does he eat those beans that we give people? How does he eat a bean?
Kind of like, does Diglett have feet?
Yeah.
The eternal questions.
Like, magnets. How do they work? Oh, I'm pretty sure I tried to tell you to name your Magnemite ICP after the Insane Clown Posse.
Yeah.
After their famous song,
Magic.
Do you think
children's science fair projects are like, magnets, how do they work? Except, like, with a Magnemite?
Yeah, Magnemites, how do they work?
Exactly.
What's Grimer made of?
I just noticed the side of my video is cut off.
Oh, is it?
Yeah, you can see.
Oh, yeah, it is cropped just a little bit.
Yeah, see, there's no W in Watson.
Yeah, yeah. Yeah, I have to kind of shrink the screens a little bit and crop them in certain ways to make them both fit, like, relatively decently.
Mm-hmm.
But yeah, every once in a while, the edges get a bit cut off. I'll try and continue to refine that as we go. And then we get all worked up by this boy.
Right?
That boy just works me up.
In what way?
All of them. What? What? You're giving me a look. You asked the question like you didn't want the answer.
I don't understand what you're saying.
He works me up. He makes me angry.
Oh, okay.
And gives me the TM. What did you think I was saying?
I couldn't tell if you were excited or what.
That's the school bell.
That's the school bell on the microphone. Like,
we're in trouble.
What terrible thing did you do to get called to the office so soon?
Whoa. Well. Lily's so disappointed in us. And when I said I didn't do anything, she's like, that's what you say. She didn't even believe me.
That's like the first time that the dialogue has changed between two answers.
And Morgan... Morgan?
Yeah?
Hello, this teacher.
Yeah, I guess we have to battle this teacher now,
The teacher wants to battle us because we beat up all her students.
Are you ready to take me on? No, I just peace.
Yeah, you just leave. You're like, I don't think I can, frankly, actually. And I decide, you know what?
You're just going to give a long stare. A long, slow, silent stare.
Just not
stare.
Say anything. She asks, are you ready to take me on?
You just don't say anything for 2 minutes.
And I say, please, I'm a student. That'd be unprofessional.
Why do you keep making...
Listen, they're there. It's only been two.
That zoom in.
Dramatic zoom.
Are you ready to take me on?
Well, then prepare for your duty.
And you know what? We both said yes.
We did.
We both said yes, Morgan. But you know what the real answer was?
Look how, like, sweet she looks, too.
You know what the real answer was
to that
question?
Okay, so here I'm already panicking. Actually, no. I thought Watson was a good choice because I didn't want to go up against a Magnemite with one of my birds.
Yeah, which is a completely reasonable answer.
Okay, here is where I admittedly make a very silly mistake because... And so understand my reasoning. If I can hit... And this is my reasoning at the time. I don't agree with myself anymore. But my thought process was, if I can hit it off with a supersonic, then maybe half of their moves won't be, like, happening.
That's true.
Effective. So then I have the upper hand.
I understand that train of thought completely. It's a huge gamble.
See, it works. So I'm like, okay, now maybe, like, 50% or so of their moves won't be working.
Mm-hmm. See,
it never once works.
And you got hit by a critical hit right there.
A critical hit.
Now, we're missing out the part where that Magnemite also just did completely half damage to my normal in a single hit.
And also, I used Magnet Bomb.
Magnet Bomb did nothing.
By the way, like 60% power did literally nothing.
Well, because it was less than four times effective. Because it's weak against both steel and electricity.
See, I wasn't... What I was thinking was electricity is also weak, so I might as well do the one with more power.
Yeah.
So yeah, now I know I need to make the call.
Uh-huh.
The switching call.
You know, there's a decision to be made here, and it's not going to be made lightly. And I'm between my mixtape and this Meowth right now.
So
and
you
I'm
took down the Magnemite.
I did, because mixtape was super effective against it. The Magnemite took out half of my health on my Meowth.
So, see, understand my fear now. I have two bird Pokemon.
Yeah.
And Ratatouille, what level is he? Like...
8? 9?
Not great.
Very hard. I believe he's 8.
It's very hard to see in that tiny screen.
Yeah. No, because we had just been crushing it up until this point. Like, no real big challenge. And now all of a sudden we realize,
also, we
oh
both
no.
have four Pokemon, so like that's more than anyone here is going to have.
Absolutely. We didn't think we'd be going up against like the two worst potential ones for us.
So yeah, I had to make the call. Thundershock already isn't great. Not a great move.
But it's also not the worst.
Could be worse, yeah.
And now this bite brings my mixtape down to 8 and flinches me so I can't actually use it. I keep on almost going down to hit potion instead of...
So, okay, my reasoning for using Astonish here is because all the other moves are not very effective.
And Astonish has a chance of flinching.
Yeah, a pretty high one, actually.
That's a reasonable course of action, frankly.
It's the only thing that's, like, not gonna do... Because, like, imagine what, you know, like, normal, leaf...
Absolutely.
Peck. Steel is strong. And so is, electric.
And now I'm with my Peter Peppers against this Meowth because Bite would just completely murder Sausage and is taking me down already to half health. This Meowth is fierce. That Bite attack straight up nearly kills my Peter Pepper.
I tried to use something that wasn't Astonish and that also didn't work. Now I'm down to 11 and paralyzed. Static paralyzed me.
Yeah. No, it was crazy. At this point, we're both panicking.
Like, literally, like, hyperventilating.
Like, don't know what to do.
Oh, I hate watching this because it hurts.
And I realized, like, oh man, that Meowth is going to kill probably one of my Pokemon. There's almost no way it can't.
Yeah, and also, look at this. Ratatouille is now also down to 11. And I can't switch in Pico.
And I decide here to switch into normal. And you're switched into Ratatouille.
That was one hit.
One hit does that.
Oh,
at low levels like this, one hit, even from not a super effective move, can just be absolutely crushing.
Also, like Static could have paralyzed me. None of these moves are very effective.
No.
I don't have a single move on my entire team that's effective.
And
this is only the first Pokemon.
Yeah, here I switch into normal, hoping that this will go all right.
Bite wasn't very effective, though.
It goes okay with that, and I hope that I can get my bite off first.
Ratatouille!
Ratatouille!
This is where the madness happens, because I've lost one Pokemon already.
And so you go into a bit of a panic, and you're still on the first Pokemon.
Yeah, and what? I can't switch into Pico. I can't switch into Potato. He's also paralyzed. The only chance I have is Watson, and that didn't go over great before.
And here I lose normal. And both of us are freaking out!
Your poor normal!
My poor normal! I just caught that poor baby!
And what am I supposed to do? I can't switch in Pico. He's literally going to destroy me.
But you do have Rock Smash.
I don't think I realized that at the time.
Because Rock Smash would have been super effective.
Oh, wait, no, I do go for it.
You realize it's the only choice because everything else will kill you. And I'm panicking. I don't know who to send out because that Meowth only has a little bit of HP left.
Okay, yeah, here we go.
Oh, if we had realized that sooner.
Yeah, but I just didn't want to switch him in because...
No, it's completely fair. Because it's an electric type and you don't switch in flying types against electric.
Exactly. So here I'm finally like, oh, okay. I've got this level 10 Pokemon. I can take this Meowth.
Yeah, and you've got Rock Smash, which would be super effective.
And this is where Bite happens, which... Flinch!
Flinch!
No Rock Smash for me, but I might as well try it.
I survive one bite from Meowth and take it down.
Okay, down to 10?
Yeah, and you think, hey, maybe I can still do it. I just need to be hit. I just need to hit it once more.
But one more bite. One more bite and I'm gone.
One more bite and you are gone.
But I can't switch into Potato because he's paralyzed.
And so we're freaking out.
I can't switch into Watson.
Though... I think that's exactly what you do. And at this point, I'm just trying to coach you through it because we're trying to get through with as little losses as possible.
Yeah, you've won here already at this point. You lost Nurmal.
I have lost Nurmal in the bloodbath that this teacher has brought upon our family.
This horrible woman, this evil, evil.
Who's like, oh, I saw that you beat children. Time to destroy you as an adult.
Time to take you down a few pegs.
Oh,
just
we
like,
were the rising
just like
star.
Superstar Jeremy.
Oh, Jeremy.
Rising star Jeremy.
I understand his struggle now, and you decide you're just going to go for it. You're going to try it.
Nope. Pico.
And it doesn't. Help.
Oh, Pico.
Poor, poor Pico.
And now...
You have no choice.
I can't lose Potato.
No.
This is my only option.
You have no choice. I mean, You try and make it happen.
All I could hope for was that because Watson, like Magnemites tend to be speedier, that Watson would have the speed on.
Absolutely. And frankly, Rowlet is paralyzed.
So that's, yeah.
That's already a disaster.
That's already half speed because
so you're not gonna
takes
go
away
first.
Speed. Yeah. And here it is. The devastating bite. I use Magnet Bomb.
And you survive with 3 HP. And
then
but
this
don't
happens.
Take it out! And now, we have a very serious and long discussion.
See that woman's face on your screen? That's like a fourth of how I'm feeling right now.
Here we have a really long discussion because frankly, it's looking like it's the end of the Nuzlocke for you. You can't go first against this Meowth.
Because the Meowth, we already know, goes first.
And your Rowlet surely isn't going to go first.
And I really, really don't want to lose Rowlet. Like, because as much as I love this Magnemite, I don't want to lose my
your
starter.
Your starter?
And that would be devastating.
And so you just don't know what to do. And so and there's no way, like, Rowlet is going to die first. Like, it's not going to kill Meowth in time because the Meowth is fast. And
We're trying to figure out what we do when I inevitably lose this Nuzlocke run, like completely.
Yeah, because what do we do? We hadn't figured out what we were going to do if somebody were to lose, especially this early. We never thought it would be possible to lose this early.
And we haven't even contemplated it. Okay, so yeah, here is where...
Here, I tell Morgan to break the rules.
And I protest. I do.
She doesn't want to do it, but I'm saying, no, we can't end this episode. We can't end this video series on episode 3.
Which is absolutely how this is going. I've already lost 2.
Like, and then we're trying to figure out, would you just watch me play through the rest of the game? But I don't think that's as exciting.
Yeah, okay, so now I can say that, like, now that it's been a few episodes, and we're on episode 5, I think, that we've recorded, we figure out the penalty. Which
yeah.
isn't ending, it's just, you know.
No, we release half of our team of whatever we have at that point, and then we wonder trade the other half.
And then
if we do a full team wipe.
The wonder traded half is the half that we continue with.
Yeah. And so that is what we will do once like we die in our Nuzlocke.
Because no one wants to just see one person get eliminated in episode 3 and just like
now what that
not
could
get
mean
to play.
Is we trade off 3 of our Pokemon and then do get 3 Young Gooses.
Why is that?
I mean, I'm just saying that's a physical possibility.
Oh, no, with the Wonder Trade?
Yeah.
Yeah.
That's a complete possibility. We have to stick with whatever those 3 are, so it is a punishment.
So yeah, here's where you tell me, do it.
Do it.
Just do it.
And I tell you.
Like, this is the one time we'll do this. It's not...
It's the one break.
And then this happens.
And then this happens.
So I'm like, okay, here, surely.
Surely, you can just survive it.
And then it goes again.
But it turns out...
And then I flinch.
You flinch. And we're like, well, you still have one more hit.
And then you flinch again.
The Nuzlocke knew we broke the rules.
It was like, oh, no, you don't. I'm going to take you right back down to where you were, you little numbskull.
They would not let us win. And we're just freaking out. And we decided, you know what? The Nuzlocke has spoken. Clearly.
Clearly, this is the end for me. Like, I can't continue.
The game doesn't want us to. Otherwise, that Meowth wouldn't have, like, flinched you so many times. Look at that saucy stare that Meowth is giving
you. Yeah, do you see that camera move? And then Magnemite's like, shit.
That Magnemite knows what's about to happen.
And then I lose Watson. Look at that X in its eye.
You lose Watson. And we accept.
I'm like, all right.
We accept that this is where the video is. Apparently, we're going to have to figure out.
What I do once I've lost.
What you do. Because what else can you do?
Look at her. Oh, she's so...
You're paralyzed, and you've got 11 HP left.
Like, there's no way that I'm going first, and that bite is going to take me out for sure. And in the next turn, I'm probably still going to be paralyzed.
Yeah. Well, you're not going to not be paralyzed.
And then he uses bite.
And then you survive. And don't get paralyzed, and you take down the Meowth.
And I win with only 4 HP.
And Potato lives.
Potato lives!
And I'm like actually on the verge of tears. Because it was such an emotional moment. We were so numb.
Seriously.
And then she gives us 5 great balls like, here, I murdered 3 of your Pokemon.
I murdered 3 of your best friends.
Go catch some new ones, I guess. She destroyed. I mean, she destroyed my normal. I'm lucky I only lost 1 in this battle.
I can't believe I pulled it through at the end, though. I can't believe Potato survived.
With
that,
4 HP
that
and...
That beautiful bird.
4 HP and paralyzed.
And Bite could have flinched. Paralyzed could have paralyzed me.
Yeah. I'm going to say it now. Potato is an angel sent from heaven.
It's so true.
Explain those wings if he's not.
And did you see his face when he was like going up against the Meowth? He's like, I got this. It's okay. He was still smiling.
He was chill. He knew because he's the angel of light and is protected and cannot die.
And then here everyone's like, all right, be good to your Pokemon.
The one you have left?
I've completed my lesson, that's for sure.
That was like harder than most first gym badges are.
Right?
Yeah. Like that's some Brock in Pokemon Red and Blue business because no one in those games except for maybe your starter has anything strong against Rock.
Right. I hope you get close to a lot of people.
Not you anymore. I never want to see your face again. Here comes Lily. You seem to be in perfect sync with your Meowth, don't you? Which is very cruel that she said that. And Magnemite. They have both passed. You both seem to be in sync with your dead Pokemon, don't you?
She's like, oh, you sure were in sync. Remember when I told you not to hurt them? But you wish you'd listen to me.
Yeah, you're not wrong. You're not wrong.
You know, I was really impressed seeing how you battled.
Here, I'm getting...
Yeah, I'm sure you were.
At school.
Yeah, impressed by that battle with the teacher.
You were able to save Nebby. You were chosen.
Tauros again.
And how is Joe's pooped?
Muar.
How is so excited to see that Tauros. It is the kahunas.
I guess so. Why is it always, like, blocking everyone's way?
I don't know.
Also, we could totally just walk around it, right?
Like, we absolutely could.
Whoa. And all you and I want to do is just go to the Pokemon Center and...
Yeah, and release our sad, dead Pokemon. And we've got to watch this nonsense about a Tauros when we're all heartbroken.
Oh, the places you'll go, child.
Thanks, Dr. Seuss. Sorry, I was angry still.
Yeah, right?
About the loss. Able to calm a raging Pokemon.
It's like everyone is mocking us now.
Yeah. You know what he can't quell? The rage inside me after my profound loss of Nurmal.
Real quick, can we check the Audacity and make sure that the...
I am watching it as we've been recording this. Sweet. It's totally fine.
Ugh, I don't feel like eating. How?
Yeah, how can you eat after you've just seen murder? Oh, how? And right. Here we go.
Here we go.
We've got to say goodbye.
All right, I'll go first.
Because
okay. I went first. Watson, I was really, really excited to go on my adventure with you. I really thought you were going to give me some really great type coverage, but I couldn't protect you. I'm sorry I used Supersonic so many times. Oh, I guess this is it. This is where we say goodbye. I hope wherever you go, in the clouds or, you know, back out into the... Not on the ground. I don't like to think about it that way. I hope you're happy. I loved you so much. I would have loved you even more.
Morgan.
This is...
Morgan, do Magnemite dream of Electric Mareep?
All right, and then here... Are you going with your Nurmal first?
Yeah, this is my turn. Wait, no. I think you're actually still going.
I'm
going
to go with Ratatouille. Goodbye,
I honestly
Ratatouille.
Don't remember.
I was really, really proud of your name. And I was also really excited for you to turn into a giant, chubby Alola Raticate. And, you were the third Pokemon I ever caught, and I really thought we were going to go far. And I really like your mustache, and I really like the funny little pattern on your belly. Goodbye.
Now, Nurmal, it's time we have a small talk. Now, I know you hate Mondays, and I know you love lasagna, because, and you're very cute, because those are just the things I know about Garfield, and I'm pretty sure you're just Lady Garfield. But, Nurmal, you're going to a place where there's so much lasagna. And lots of eyelash curlers for your long cat eyelashes that you have. I'm glad I'll never see you turn into a Persian.
Yeah, maybe you're saving him from an inevitable fate.
from the terrible, terrible doom that
maybe
is to become.
Maybe this is the best reality for Nurmal, honestly.
I'll see you up there in little Nurmal heaven, buddy.
You were really excited to use Nurmal.
It's a cool Pokemon. I really like Alola Meowth. And then I had to release him.
All right, time for my third death here.
Oh.
Pico, you were my first catch other than Rowlet. And I really, really like you. And I really liked your name. And I really like how the end of your beak is black. And I really like how you look like one of those little like water donkey birds that like goes down in the water, and
it does look like a water donkey bird.
I really like how the back of your hair goes up into a point, and I really like how the top of your hair is red, and I'm really gonna miss you, and I'll never forget you, and it would have been really nice to see what you grow up into, because frankly I don't really know what it is. I'll never forget you.
You beautiful I messed that up. That's my bad.
Goodbye, Pico. It's just me and Potato now. Get out of here! Get out of here! Just go! I don't want to see you anymore!
And there they all go. Down on the lower screen. Oh no, Morgan. Morgan, you've got one Pokemon.
I've got just Potato.
How are we gonna do a Nuzlocke like this?
It's me and Potato, lone wolves.
Oh,
hitting the town together.
Hitting that new beachfront.
And somehow all of these people are out at night.
Yeah, I was very confused by that. Of like, is it just really hot out at night so you can still be in a bikini?
I guess so.
Because nighttime does not seem like the prime bikini weather.
Look, that person's like sun tanning in the dark.
They're going to have a...
So excited for beach time.
Even at night. Beach time, yeah!
I don't need any of it.
Hey, you! You've come to Alola from someplace far off, haven't you?
Can you see the sadness in my eyes? Is that how you know?
You can see the darkness?
Hello, darkness, my old friend. Is that why it's always nighttime?
It's because you're constantly... There's a dark
shadow
darkness. Hanging over Alola. That girl just told us to say hi to people. That's literally all she did.
The greeting is saying Alola, which would be like going to Hawaii and everyone saying Hawaii.
Which I think is maybe actually what we should start doing. Like right now we should do California.
United States of America.
Are we really that united? No, I'm not going to go there.
Oh, please don't go there.
This man, the Wingles fly. And their droppings fall. The beauty of nature, he says.
I'm not interested in your haikus.
Is that a haiku? He was just talking about how he loves Wingle poop.
I don't know. I'm too sad to even contemplate it.
No, we didn't catch that the first time around.
No, I totally did.
Oh, really? I did not.
It's because you don't listen to me.
Oh, well.
How are you?
Oh, and here we have gotten our Rotom dexes upgraded so we can take photos.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. And look, we take a little selfie.
And we don't want to end the episode here because that would just be too sad.
Bummed out beyond all belief.
Lily always looks surprised or sad. I understand.
Put that little trickster in your bag, because what I've learned from Lily is that that's where Pokemon belong.
You guys go on ahead. I'll catch up later.
Rotom's just a show-off. And right as our friends leave us, this creepy old man approaches. Just this middle-aged man who's like, oh, you've got a camera. Let me show you what you can do with a camera. Trying to get us hooked on cracked walls.
Give him a tap.
And so, in order to mourn our Pokemon,
we just take pictures of other Pokemon.
We just start distracting ourselves. Now, deep down, I really hoped that this Pokemon would jump out at me and somehow we would get a chance to catch it.
I know.
Right? Because I really want a Pikachu in this game.
Beautiful.
And then you start overthinking it at this point.
No, because I was. Because I didn't know. Oh, it's so cute. Because I was like, I guess this is just it. We just take the same picture. Mm-hmm. And I was like, I want to put a little bit of flair into it. What about the rule of thirds?
And so you start incorporating the rule of thirds.
Which, it's perfect. The palm tree is in the one third. The Pikachu is in the other third.
I'm not saying it's a bad picture.
The landscape is in the upper quadrant. It's perfect.
And listen, it's a nice photo, but given what they want you to photo...
I didn't know what they wanted. It just says to choose the best... Pick which one I want to show off. This is the one I want to show off.
Not knowing that they would be grading it.
Yeah, you got 1,500 thumbs up.
And, you got like 100. I cut away from it.
But then I went back and I did it better. And then I got like way more. I got like 1,400.
Yeah, you did it better than me the second time around. We were all very proud.
Like almost 2,000.
And this is where we learned something about Lily, where she asked me if I pick out all my own clothes.
My mom does it.
And yeah, I waited.
Hi, you said my mom does it.
Yeah, and she's like, oh, your mom has great taste. And then we learned that Lily has her mom pick out all her clothes.
I just always worn the clothes that my mother wanted me to wear.
No, we've never seen Lily's mom.
It's true.
And she apparently doesn't know how to shop for herself.
We got the lens case. Yeah. I don't remember getting that.
It's how we change our eye color if we want to.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. We have something in common. Because we have the same lens case? Okay.
I guess that's the only thing we have in common.
Shopping montage!
Shopping montage!
We shopped our hearts out because we were in mourning.
It's the only way I can feel again.
And so we just needed to completely cover up any feeling of loss or sadness that we might have had.
I need my shirt to match my hat. That shirt is very styling.
With some very good shoppings that we did. And then also, a good old-fashioned hair, dude.
I'm trying to decide what a romantic tuck means.
But you decide to go for it.
Yeah. I really like how their heads at super speed are just like,
are
they're
just
like
constantly
head-banging.
Bobbing. Yeah. It's a good look. And then we get our fresh, good styles.
Such fresh style. Look at that. Look at that nice boy.
Look at that modern romantic tuck that you've got.
I had no idea what romantic tuck would be.
I feel like it looks good.
I like it.
Yeah. I think it's a style.
And then here's where I notice, oh no, my hat.
Your hat is gone. And you start panicking. You're like, who can I talk to?
Yeah, I walk around trying to talk to everyone about my hat.
To get your hat back.
In the end, I realized I can't get my hat back, apparently.
And here we decide to have our new Pokemon friend in the area.
Yours is a Yungoose.
And I get a Yungoose. And you see that I got a Yungoose in that grass.
And I'm like trying my fastest to get away.
You're like, let me not get that Yungoose, though.
I'm pretty sure I just wanted the Pokeball that was over there.
Can I not have a Yungoose, though?
Hey, you have way more options. I mean, you have way more Pokemon that you can pick from when you're going into a battle.
That is true.
This is my new friend.
Get a Wingull.
Another flying type.
Because, of course, you didn't have enough flying types just yet.
But at least this will give me water type coverage.
You know what? That's good to have. Absolutely.
But yeah, another flying type. Magnemites are even worse for me now.
They're just going to tear through you like it's nobody's business. And I'm trying to figure out what I should do because I have no idea what type Yungoose is. So I'm scared of being hurt again.
Yeah. Aren't we all at this
point? These battles went on for a little while, so I cut into it.
But yeah, now, if I wasn't afraid of Magnemite before, oh boy, am I afraid of it now.
Knowing that all you have is a Rowlet and a Wingull to your name, and there's no other route in sight.
It's so sad.
And yeah, we catch these new friends. What do you think of Wingull and Yungoose?
I think Yungoose is kind of silly.
Yungoose is kind of silly. He's mostly teeth.
But it's kind of cute how he's mostly teeth and his teeth are so sharp.
That is true. Oh, my Yungoose is also a lady. Because apparently there's just
Wingull
no men
also,
in this
I'm
game.
I'm pretty sure my Wingull is a dude. Dude Wingull.
Oh, yeah?
I think so. But yeah, here's where I'm like, oh man. I already named my other Picky Peck Pico, so I can't name my Wingull Pico.
After the Wingull in Ruby and Sapphire.
Exactly. That would have been even more perfect.
Yeah.
I didn't know I would run into a Wingull, though, so soon.
Yeah, who would have anticipated? I mean, I guess a seagull on an island makes sense, you know?
Yeah.
And I'm also struggling to what to call my new Yungoose.
I really like what you settled on, though.
Yeah, no, I'm a fan. Not
wow.
just of the name, but also of the burgers that they provide.
Clarles
Jr. Like Carl's Jr., the fast food establishment.
Clarles Jr. It's very cute.
And you decide?
Briny.
Yeah. After the captain.
Oh, wait, no. Briny is a lady.
Wait, who's Briny?
No, I'm just saying.
Oh, you're saying your Briny is a lady. It is a captain in Ruby and Sapphire, the one who owned Pico. But can you ever really own a Pokemon?
So this is fine.
Yeah. And this is about where we call it for this episode. Like, we've got fresh new fashions, you know?
Mm-hmm.
Fresh new fashions, brand new Pokemon. We've struggled and we've had a loss. We've had on one side, a fairly significant loss.
I lost a lot. I lost almost everything.
But we're going to come back, Morgan. Stronger and better than ever.
Well, I don't know about that last part, but we'll definitely be back.
Listen, nothing can stop the Nuzlocke run.
Thanks for tuning in to this horrific show. At least we got our fresh new styles. I'm happy about that.
Exactly. We look good, but we don't feel good. See you next time.
Hey everyone, it's Luke. Just wanted to say thanks for watching our videos. Morgan and I really appreciate it. If you could take a moment to like our video, write us a comment, and subscribe to our channel, your support and sharing our channel with your friends always means so much to us. It just absolutely brightens our day. We'll have new episodes of our dual Pokemon Nuzlocke coming out every Monday and Thursday, and we'll try to make sure they're nice, chunky episodes for all y'all. Thanks for sticking around, and we'll see you in the next episode.